good news, it seems like the longtime feud between Selena Gomez and Bella Hadid is finally over, and we have all the details. I'm Gabby Conti.
I'm Jana Rosenberg, and this is What's Hot on Hollywire. As you may remember, there's always been bad blood between Selena Gomez and Bella Hadid, which, like most female feuds throughout history, traces back to a boy. In this case, that guy is the Weeknd. There was definitely drama when Selena Gomez started dating him.
I mean, why? Ladies, come on. Let's stick together.
I was gonna say,
let's not let the people that oppress us break us apart, all right? So
right?
Let's stand up, and it doesn't matter if he dated you and then dated her. Like, who cares? You should have something in common. Be friends.
Honestly, like, you have similar tastes, which is good taste. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't know, that's my opinion.
I get it. Look, I mean, I am not immediately besties with anyone who's dated any of my exes, but
same
eventually
here.
I am, because you know what, we've both been through it.
Yeah.
So we get it. So if you don't remember, Hadid dated The Weeknd from 2015 to 2019. Very long relationship,
mm-hmm.
especially by Hollywood standards.
Mm-hmm.
And in their off periods, The Weeknd dated Gomez. And then in 2009, Bella and The Weeknd split for good, and Gomez commented on a photo of the model that she had posted of in a Dior look by saying stunning with a heart-eyed emoji. And then Selenators pointed out that Hadid actually deleted the photo without any like explanation. And so when they told it to Gomez, Gomez commented that sucked, but also asked fans not to harass the model simply because they had the same XPF. You know, she's a wonderful person and it was all a misunderstanding, Gomez told her fans.
Wow, I can't believe she deleted that comment. That is a statement without saying a statement.
It's just like, I don't want your support, like no thank you. I think it was the comment, and I think she also deleted the post too.
You know, I have to say, I think, you know, Bella and The Weeknd have a really long history and there's a lot of emotions there from what we can see. I mean, if you date someone for 5 or 6 years, it's like you're obviously gonna be very like connected to them emotionally. So I feel like maybe Selena's just her weak spot and she's like, you know what, I just can't really handle that, and I get that.
Also, The Weeknd could have been playing the two of them. Like, how do we know the timelines could have crisscrossed, especially if they were off and on for those 4 years? And whose fault is that? It would be The Weeknd. It wouldn't be these innocent ladies.
Gabby to tell you what's going down in the male brain, you know?
Personally, I think. I know that happens a lot.
But now it seems like Gomez and Hadid are fine. Gomez follows the model on Instagram, and while Hadid does not follow her back, the two will often like each other's posts. That's nice. Which is almost more flattering for Selena because her posts don't come up on Bella's feed. So true, oh my gosh. So Bella is like searching Selena Gomez on IG and then going through and liking her post. Or does Bella not realize that Selena and the rest of the world can tell that she's not following the singer? That's a very good point.
Have you ever done that?
Yes.
Like, so you like unfollow someone and you don't want them to know you unfollow them. So to keep up the charade, you mm-hmm. go through and like their photos. But obviously they could just search your name. And also it's not like Bella and Selena both are not following a lot of people.
Right.
They have millions of followers. Bella is following, I think, like 300 something people, and Selena is following even less, 100 and something people. And of those 100 and something people she's following, Bella is one of the people she's still following, but Bella can't fit Selena in the 300 people she's following. I mean, just girl.
Again, like I feel it for Bella in this example, so maybe it's just she doesn't want to see her posts every day, you know?
But that's why you mute it. You mute the post.
True,
you don't unfollow, you mute it. So I think what really should happen right now, you know, like now that it's out, now the cat is out of the bag, Bella and Selena, whoever unfollowed who, let's follow each other, mute, and then selectively like. Okay, this is just giving me a headache, honestly. Well, most recently, Hadid liked Selena Gomez's post of her in an all black with these pink Mickey Mouse gloves, and the caption said, bye, which perhaps is a farewell to Gomez's squeaky clean Disney past, or is Hadid liking this post because she's like saying, bye, girl, bye. Well, I'm not trying to start anything. You know, I think it was just, she looked cute. Selena looked cute. I'm hoping that she just was, you know, showing support.
I'm sure.
And trying to keep up the charade that she is not following Selena Gomez.
I don't know, but I do know Selena always keeps it super positive and she never has anything bad to say about anyone.
She's the nicest.
She's super sweet.
She's legit the nicest.
Yeah, so what do you guys think is going on here with the Selena and Bella controversy? That might even not be controversy. We're just telling you the facts and what we know. Can you be friends with someone that your ex dated?
Yes. It's like not hard.
Maybe.
It was probably his fault. So just be friends, okay?
She's not wrong.
Women need to support other women. Hard stop.
This is true. Okay, let us know what you guys think. I'm Jana Rosenberg.
I'm Gabby Conti, and follow us at Hollywire for your celebrity connection.